Orbax are here today with Dr. Joanne O'Meara, and we're going to be discussing soap bubbles. Now, what we have here is a really simple setup. It's a tube, open at one end, it goes up, goes all the way across, and comes back down as open over here. This will actually allow us to blow two different size bubbles on either end here.
Right. And so we've got a little valve in the middle. So right now we've got it connected to this side. So we're going to get you to create a little bubble on that side. Just a little one. And then we move the valve over and we can blow a bubble on that side. Okay. So we're going to make this one significantly bigger than that one.
Right. And I guess the question would be, if we open this tube and let them both have exposure to the same atmosphere inside of this, what happens to these bubbles?
What would happen?
I guess naively, somebody would think that they would equilibrate in size, right? So this big bubble is going to push out a bunch of air. It's going to go across to the small bubble and it's going to even them out
and
in size.
When they're about the same size, they'll just kind of stop.
So let's see.
All right. Let's open it up.
Now, if we watch, that's actually not what's happening at all. You can see this one here is getting a little bit smaller and a little bit smaller. And this one's getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And that's because the pressure caused by the soap film is inversely proportional to the radius. The smaller the radius, the more pressure is exerted on that bubble. And it's actually pushing all the material across, up and over into this great big one. Oh, jeez. Oh, terrifying.
That was so much pressure. It exploded.
Wow. So it seems we're done soap filming this video now.
Good.
So we've popped the bubble on
surface tension
filming. get back to work.